14 days is acceptable by us. Another 14 days, you didn't communicate to us that you are going to do another 14 days after 14 days. They have tested negative, and then they have given them the paper. Why are they giving them another 14 days? That is one. Two, all the police, the documents, this passport belongs to the federal government of Nigeria. In line with international practice, no any country have the right to seize the international passport of another country. They are not in my hand. I just withdraw it from there. They seize it.
I know, you have that.
I said they seize it. And then you know, the deputy, all the passport of Nigeria, they seize. Asking, he was released yesterday. Why are they seizing Nigerian passport? It not belong to the China. If you seize Nigerian passport, it's like you are seizing Nigeria as a whole. It's not acceptable. That's another two. The third one I'm going to tell you, you didn't communicate to us that you are going to go to all the Nigerian houses and then you are going to ask them to come out and go and quarantine them. Did you communicate to us? No. Nobody communicate to us. If you want to do your policy of 14 days, shut down everybody. Don't discriminate. Everybody, you sit.
Treat our ambassador is very important, very, very important, and I'm glad you did that. But how you treat our citizens is more important.
I know,
to us,
yes, yes.
Than even how you treat the ambassador.
Yes, yes. So,
I just want to thank you, Graham. I'm sure you know my colleagues will have some comments as well. You said you haven't seen any of the videos that are out there. I'm at liberty to show them to you. Everybody has a phone if you want, if that will convince you, because you said you haven't had an official complaint. You know what our government, including those of us here, the resistance we put up just to allow your medical personnel to come in a couple of days ago. Nigerians were worried for good reason because we have this virus out there. And we're almost undiplomatic the way I'm talking, but it's because I am actually upset about what's going on. So, I'm not sure how you want to address this. Have you spoken to your Nigerian counterpart in China? Have you spoken to the Nigerian ambassador in China?
No.
You haven't?
No.
Have you spoken
not
to...
Not on this issue.
I'm talking about this issue. Have you spoken to any official Chinese of the Chinese government in China?
Definitely. We have to, like I promised the foreign minister, we take the very...
But you have not.
No, we have done it. But
you spoke to the Chinese government?
Oh, we're still waiting for the... Because we are here. We don't get the picture, the whole picture. So, but we have to report the concern from Right Honourable Speaker and the Minister, we take it very seriously.
Yeah, my order you have, please, by Monday, because I'm aware that this is a weekend, but by Monday, so we have a couple of days.
On Tuesday.
Please, or Tuesday, because Monday is...
To my fellow African diaspora, a very good day to all of you. My name is Ambassador Arikana Chihombori Kwao. Over the past couple of days, I've received many messages, emails, phone calls, and video clippings of the abuse that is being meted to our fellow African diaspora living in China. I've watched in horror Africans roaming the streets of China with their possessions after being evicted out of their homes simply because they're Africans. I've watched in horror Africans roaming the streets with their suitcases and at times with nothing at all, roaming the streets after being thrown out of their hotel rooms simply because they're Africans. I have watched in horror women carrying babies roaming the streets of China with nowhere to go after being thrown out of their homes simply because they are Africans. I've heard many stories of Africans who are married to Chinese being separated from their husbands or wives simply because they were Africans. I've heard stories about Africans being forced to take COVID-19 tests simply because they're Africans. In many cases, these individuals did not meet criteria for testing, or they had been quarantined for the specified time period as mandated by the under-pandemic laws of China. Not once have I heard any complaints of any African disobeying the under-pandemic laws of China. Why is it then that Africans are being singled out and mistreated? This situation is not acceptable. It is wrong, and it will not be tolerated. To President Xi, I say, while you have enjoyed good relationships with all the African leaders, it is precisely because of that that you should do the right thing. You are sitting in the big boy's chair, and we are asking you